Subscribe and press the bell icon to never miss an update from First Post.
Hello and welcome to First Day First Showsha. Today we are going to review Thugs of Hindustan in 10 questions and 0 spoilers. Let's dive straight in. The latest release from Yashraj offers you a few things you haven't yet seen in Hindi films so far, mainly in terms of look and feel. But that isn't enough to elevate it to must-watch levels because the film is bland and uninspiring for the most. The ships and pirates theme seems to be only a cosmetic inspiration for Thugs of Hindustan. In terms of the plot, Thugs is quite different from Jack Sparrow's escapades. The story of Thugs is inspired from an 1839 novel titled Confessions of a Thug. Set in the 19th century, when the British East India Company gained a stranglehold over India's princely states, the film tracks a bunch of seafaring rebel warriors who are out to save their land and people from the clutches of a British officer named Clive. Aamir's character Firangi, an unscrupulous small-time scoundrel, is the twist in the tale. The two superstars don't have too many scenes together, and to be honest, none of them truly stand out considering how long it has taken for the two of them to come together on the big screen. If anything, this aspect is special only in theory, not really adding to the film in any way. Fatima Sana Sheikh gets the bigger role, while Katrina Kaif is there for only a few minutes outside of the two songs she's in. Fatima's character Zafira is the only one who gets a proper backstory in the film, and she performs action well. However, the film deserved to focus on her more, since she's the only one who genuinely has stakes in the story. The best thing about Thugs of Hindustan is probably the unpredictability of Aamir Khan's character Firangi. You never know when he'll double-cross whom, so the uncertainty of it keeps you mildly interested. Yet, beyond a point, even the unpredictability becomes predictable. It's refreshing though to see Aamir Khan play an actual character who doesn't bring everything to a standstill so he can sermonize on camera. The film has an interesting setup. Patriotism, Azadi, adventure, the works. And some of the production design is outstanding as well. But it does a disservice to it all because of the flat writing. The film had an opportunity to create an immersive ride full of thrills and heart-stopping moments. But instead, what you get is old-school Bollywood masala, which to be honest is not even that masaledar. It begs the question, why is writing given the least amount of attention in commercial Hindi cinema? From the technique point of view, it's the production design of the film that stands out. There's a lot of detail in the world of the film, though I can't comment on how accurate it is for the time it's set in. You'll find it hard to think of a Hindi film that has such a distinct feel to it. However, this is let down to some extent by the VFX, which still lacks the finesse and adherence to the laws of physics, which somehow seems to be staple stuff for Hindi action extravaganzas. Watchable, it certainly is. As I mentioned earlier, certain technical aspects stand out, and Aamir Khan in a different avatar gives it a few more strands of hope. Don't go in with heavy expectations, and you might walk away from the film moderately entertained. So I give 2.5 stars out of 5 for Vijay Krishna Acharya's Thugs of Hindustan. The film won't steal your heart away, but watch it with an open mind, and you might find it partially worth your time. That's it then for this week's First Day First Showsha. We'll be back very soon with yet another movie review. Till then, bye-bye.